Hi, I'm Tao. I'm a software engineer on PyTorch Mobile team. Today, I'm going to talk to you about the PyTorch Mobile support for CoreML Delegate. On-device machine learning can bring a range of benefits by moving computations to be local with data. It can improve privacy, ensure our feature work even without internet connectivity, and reduce latency. But on mobile devices, we are always power constrained, so it's critical that we perform computations as efficient as possible. Thankfully, modern devices have a range of specialist chips that can really help. GPUs, DSPs, and new ML dedicated hardware accelerators, also known as NPUs, can improve the power efficiency beyond utilizing the CPU alone. Each of these chips is suited to different tasks. Mobile devices can have different configurations of these chips. This complexity can make it hard for developers to best utilize the hardware. PyTorch Mobile provides a unified runtime for computation offload to different backends to improve developer efficiency and performance. On iOS, we support running models on GPU and CoreML. On Android, we support Vulkan and Android and API. The PyTorch CoreML Delegate was introduced in PyTorch 1.10. It can delegate a model execution to CoreML framework at runtime on iOS devices. We provide an experimental interface to let you target PyTorch models to CoreML with a consistency Python API. You get the same familiar PyTorch APIs with no need to write Objective-C or Swift code. You can offload directly from CPU to dedicated hardware to get maximum performance out of your device. To get started, first download the PyTorch nightly build on your macOS machine. You also need to install CoreML tools. And finally, you'll be using the CoreML Delegate API to optimize your torch grid model to run on CoreML. Here is a code snippet of how to use the CoreML Delegate on a pre-trained MobileNet V2 model. First, we download the model from TorchVision, and then we call torch.jit.trace to convert the model to a torch grid model. Next, we use the to_backend API to target the model on CoreML backend. And finally, we save the model to a light interpreter compatible format. Note, we need to provide input and output shape information to do shape inference when converting the model. We can also specify the hardware you want to target on. By default, the model will run on CPU. In this example, we use all to allow CoreML to select the best processing unit to use, which includes the neural engine if it's available. When it comes to time for runtime inference, we provide nightly cocoa pods for you to try out. You can use the new model directly within your app. There are no code changes needed. Just switch your existing model with the new model. Real-time segmentation is a feature that can really benefit from the hardware acceleration. Imagine the case of trying to determine the foreground of the users from their background for a virtual green screen effect. You want to run this continuously at low latency to provide a responsive experience to users. But typically, you're also running a lot of computation in parallel at the same time. The Instagram team is now testing PyTorch CoreML Delegate for their immersive 360 background feature. By offloading the computations from CPU to CoreML, they are seeing 80% latency reduction on iPhone 12 Pro or above devices, and 25% latency reduction on lower-end iPhones. The initial release supports a powerful but a small set of features. It supports for iOS 14 plus devices. It supports popular CV models from TorchVision, such as MobileNet V2, ResNet, ShuffleNet, and SqueezeNet. In addition, we are hardworking on the next set of features, including additional operator types, support for popular master CV models, enable quantizations, allowing flexible input shapes. We are also investigating on supporting the new CoreML model format. So that was a brief overview of PyTorch Mobile support for CoreML Delegate. Download the PyTorch Mobile nightly build and get started testing our demo app. Please do provide your feedback. For more on CoreML Delegate, check out our online tutorials. For more on PyTorch Mobile integration, please view our PyTorch iOS demo apps on GitHub. We can't wait to see how you take advantage of our full hardware capabilities with PyTorch Mobile in order to provide amazing machine learning experience on iOS. Thank you.